you find yourself in a similar position one day, will your loyalty be to the Constitution or to Donald J. Trump?
I just said my loyalty, Kristen, is to the Constitution of the United States.
Trump.
But have we talked at all about the unaffordable cost of groceries? Have we talked about the fact that
I
brought it up, but young Americans can't afford a home. You didn't bring that up. I brought that up. It's so interesting, Kristen, because I think that Kamala Harris's campaign, and unfortunately, too many of her media allies are more interested in what Donald Trump has said than what Donald Trump did in office. You're more interested in what Kamala Harris is accusing Donald Trump of than what Donald Trump actually did during his four years in office, which is deliver peace and prosperity.
What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chopped and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Now, y'all, one of the most important duties of a vice president of the United States is to be on standby and be prepared to take the reins of the country in case the president is incapable or incapacitated. Well, we have recently found out, since Kamala has stepped up to the plate, that she is not capable at all. Once foreign dictators discovered that Joe Biden's mind was gone, they started cutting up all over the world, in the Middle East, in Europe. We got wars burning all over the world, y'all. China is making moves on Taiwan, has been bumping heads with the Philippines in the middle of the ocean. People are understanding in these tumultuous times that this vice president that we currently have in office, and let me remind you that yes, she's currently the vice president of the United States, well, she is not capable. And when our enemies, foreign and domestic, see that weakness in a vice president, well, they get on the move, they get active. They get ready to slide on the United States, and that is the situation that we are in. I'm so glad, y'all, being that I've already cast my vote and been counted in the number, I'm so glad that Donald Trump chose J.D. Vance as a vice president. Because we know Donald Trump ain't no spring chicken. He's admitted it. He said, you never know. You got to pick wisely. You got to be smart because you just never know. Well, J.D. Vance is proving every day as we inch closer and closer to Election Day, he's proving that he is equipped to handle not only these reporters, but anything that the Democrat Party can throw at him. He is prepared for the job. If Donald Trump is forced to step aside, I am confident that this man can stand 10 toes down, not only with CNN and MSNBC, but with foreign dictators, America's enemies, both foreign and domestic. I think JD is ready for the job, y'all. And I think he's showing that with all of these interviews that are coming his way with these contentious reporters. I don't see much real journalism going on. Seems like these folks are on the attack. So this is what we're gonna do today. We're gonna review and react to this video of Jake Tapper, who felt like he would just go on the attack against J.D. Vance and challenge him on some real issues as if he was on a mission sent by the Democrats themselves. Let's see how J.D. handled this aggression by Jake Tapper on the State of the Union just this past weekend, y'all.
But this is the thing, Jake. We've now spent 5 minutes talking about people in Donald Trump's staff
who think he's not fit for office.
Who he fired. Oh, they didn't think he was unfit for office until they had a falling out with him because he fired them. And we're not talking about the public policy.
Well, we're actually
talk about how Americans can't afford groceries.
Can we talk about the fact that Americans can't afford the cost of housing?
Can we talk about the fact that a lot of people out there in Erie, Pennsylvania, they're the ones who suffer and die when people like Mark Esper and Mark Milley don't obey the commander-in-chief's orders.
We're talking about Donald Trump and what he says.
Yes.
And
you'd much rather talk about what Donald Trump allegedly said than
what
Donald
publicly.
Trump did in office.
I'm talking about what
he did in office, Jake.
What he said publicly.
1.5% inflation.
He wants to use the military to go after the enemy within, which is the American people.
He did not say that, Jake.
The enemy within.
He said that he was going to send the military after the American people. Show me the quote where
he said the enemy within.
He said far left lunatics. He's talking
like
about people rioting.
And Schiff.
He's talking about people rioting after the election. I think
the Pelosi's were riding after the election.
He said,
Adam Schiff was riding after the election.
You're using two separate phrases. He said about using the military that far left lunatics, people who riot in the wake of an election, people who burn down American cities in the summer of 2020. Yes, we should have a federal law enforcement.
This is what
response.
He said to Joe Rogan on Friday. The enemy within that he wants the military to go after.
No, this is the enemy within, a bigger problem than Kim Jong-un. The second part.
We have people that are really bad people that I really think want to make this country unsuccessful. That's who that enemy within.
And did he say that he wants to use the military against those people?
Use the military to go after the enemy within.
Here's the game that you're playing. He said Can I answer the question, please? He said that he wanted to use the military to go after far left lunatics who are rioting, and he also called them the enemy within. He separately, in a totally different context, in a totally different conversation, said that Nancy Pelosi and Adam Schiff were threats to this country.
Were the enemy within. He said they were the enemy
within. So every time he uses the exact same phrase, we assume that he uses
I don't know.
Military.
I don't throw around the term of enemy within to talk about using the military against going American people.
And you're asking his vice president, but you won't let me answer the question. I'm telling you that Donald Trump has said, and I agree with him, that we should use the U.S. military
to go after
people who riot, who burn down our cities.
And this was
we
what John
call
Kelly
them
was
the National Guard.
This was what John Kelly was alarmed by. The idea of using the U.S. military to go after Americans. That's not what he said.
Donald Trump never said Americans writ large. You keep on putting words in his mouth and
Or are they not Americans?
Far left people who commit acts of violence, who riot.
Now you're doing a very narrow definition of what he said, which is not what he said. That's not what he said. But let me ask you the bigger point.
Jake, he did. He said that he wanted to use the U.S. military. Let me clarify.
To go after far left lunatics,
to,
yes.
To,
and then
to
he
go
also
after
added.
People who were rioting
he
asked, and looting.
And
he
added,
never said.
He added
he
Schiff.
Never said,
and then he added the Pelosi.
He never. He
and then
said
he added people that don't want the country
Adam
to succeed.
Schiff, he said that Adam Schiff and Nancy Pelosi, he used in a separate context, in a separate conversation. And what you're doing is you're smashing two totally different conversations.
Fox asked him about this last week. And he didn't take issue with it. He said the enemy within is the biggest threat to this country.
But did he say the enemy within that he's going to use the military against Nancy Pelosi? Donald Trump offered Nancy Pelosi the National Guard on January the 6th, and according to private emails, she rejected it.
So let's talk about things that he wants to do that are feeding into this concern that people like John Kelly and General Mattis and General Milley have. He said on Friday, Special Counsel Jack Smith should get thrown out of the country. He's threatened to arrest election officials who cheated. We know that he believes a lot of people cheated that did not cheat.
Yes, if you violate the law, you should be arrested. Yes.
No one disagrees with that, but he's talking
apparently
about...
Apparently you do, based on the
no,
way you're asking
I'm
the
not,
question.
No, based on the fact that he's accused people that didn't break the law of breaking the law when it comes to the election. And if you want to revisit that, I'm happy to. But Liz Cheney, he said, should be put before a war tribunal. None of that sounds fascist to you at all?
No, of course it doesn't. Of
putting
course
Liz Cheney
doesn't.
Before a military tribunal?
First of all, I don't buy into the premise of what you're saying, Jake, because I just
said.
On things that These I know that he said, on things that I know that he said, you're imputing things, you're taking words out of context, you're taking two separate conversations and pretending
no,
that
not.
They were made at the exact same
no,
time.
Not.
So I'm rejecting the premise of your question. I frankly don't believe what you're saying about Donald Trump's words. If you'd like to put up a clip and actually put him in context, I think the American people would realize that Donald Trump is a hell of a lot more reasonable than the people like Liz Cheney who would like to lie us into war. Now, Jake, we also have to remember, I mean, step back a little bit. Well, ask yourself a basic question about network integrity. You guys talked about the Russia hoax nonstop.
The FBI was investigating so we covered them.
And so you took the words of unnamed FBI agents and put them on your network as if they were the gospel truth. You did it again and again. A viewer of your network would have believed that Donald Trump and Vladimir Putin conspired in 2016.
No.
That was totally and preposterously false.
No.
Well, that's
what you just said is false. We covered an FBI investigation. I don't know why you want to talk about the FBI investigation.
You covered it in a way that gave credence to anonymous sources' accusations. You did it yourself. Your network did it, Jake. But again, can we talk about the issues that Americans care most about?
I'm talking about things that Donald Trump has said.
Yes.
If you have an issue with whether or not he's talking about the economy enough, that's between you and your running mate. I'm talking about things he has said this week.
Every single rally that he does, he talks about how he wants to unleash American energy so we can lower the cost of groceries. He talks about the fact that housing has become unaffordable. He talks about the wide open border, Jake. Kamala Harris and her allies, you know, it's interesting. Kamala Harris and her media allies, and I would put CNN in this category. You guys seem to care. Well, they should watch your network more, because you guys seem to care more about Donald Trump's past than the future of the American people. We're running this campaign on making of the American dream.
I'm specifically asking about how Donald Trump is going to be president in the future should he win. And then we're being told
he's going to pursue economic policies that lower the cost of groceries and make life more affordable again. He talks about it every single day on the campaign trail, and so do I. What you're talking about is an anonymously sourced story. Or one guy,
nothing anonymously sourced.
One guy who is a disgruntled employee.
I told you, five other people
pushed back against him and said that what he said was dishonest. So why don't we talk about the policy that's affecting American citizens and not what Donald Trump allegedly said, according to one guy who's pissed off because he got fired by Donald Trump?
I didn't bring up any of the things that he said. He said, I didn't bring up.
Brought up John Kelly, and that I just described.
I brought up John Kelly's view of Donald Trump. I didn't bring up John Kelly talking about what Donald Trump said about Hitler's generals. I didn't bring that up. I talked about John Kelly's view of Trump based on something Trump has been saying in the last week.
So
that's what I asked about.
So John Kelly makes accusations that are rejected by five people. You're talking about something
I didn't bring up.
I think that maybe implicates his overall judgment. And I think the fact that he has a worldview that's so oppositional to peace and prosperity suggests that he's not an honest arbiter here. This is not a guy, John Kelly, going to brag to Jeffrey Goldberg, who is interested in the American truth or is interested in telling an honest account of Donald Trump. He's a guy with an axe to grind because Donald Trump fired him and disagreed with him on policy.
So all those 10 people, including the former vice president, Mike Pence, all of these people have this horribly damaged worldview, and they're all just going after Donald Trump because they want to send people into war? That's really your argument?
Absolutely.
It's not like these are conservative.
Absolutely, that's my
argument.
These aren't conservative Republicans who are concerned about Donald Trump. All of these people, Jake, they came into office thinking that they could control Donald Trump. That when he said he wanted peace in the world,
Mike Pence thought he could control Donald Trump.
Yes, he did. And when he found out
really?
when he found out that he couldn't, they all turned on Donald Trump, and a lot of them got fired. And we're running, and we're trying to staff the government with people who are going to govern according to principles of peace and prosperity.
Let me ask you.
They're pissed off about it.
Let me ask you, because we're being told that we're over.
Yeah. One more question, because we have to go to this rally.
You are running to be vice president of the United States.
Of course.
And there is a 50-50 chance, maybe better, I don't know, that you're going to succeed. Are you running to be vice president of the United States, or are you running to be vice president of the red states? Because if you win, and there's a decent chance you will, you're going to be vice president of childless cat ladies. You're going to be vice president of legal Haitian migrants in Springfield, Ohio. You're going to be their vice president too. Are you running to do that?
Jake, of course I'm running to be the vice president of all Americans. I'm running because I want people to be able to afford a good life in this country. You know how I grew up. You know that I grew up in a family where things were often tough. I want, whether you're in a blue state or a red state, whether you're going to vote for Trump or you're going to vote for Harris, I want you to be able to have a good life in this country. But what's not going to happen with the broken leadership in Washington, D.C. Let me give you a statistic, Jake, because here is what the leadership of people like Kamala Harris and Nancy Pelosi and, yes, Mike Pence over 30 years in this country has led to. A person with a bachelor's degree lives 7 years longer than a person without a bachelor's degree. There are a lot of people who have gotten rich and powerful off of American decline. Some of them have had R's next to their name. Some of them have had D's next to their name. And the first person who I believe is really putting the interests of the American people first is Donald J. Trump.
And there you have it, y'all. I think JD has had enough of all the lies, of all the propaganda from these so-called journalists. Nah, he ready to stand 10 toes down, go toe to toe with the opposition. I think JD is a fighter, and I think he's proving it. I think that these journalists are getting more than they bargained for. They have bit off more than they can chew. Yeah, they have come across a VP who is ready to throw down with them and oppose them every step of the way, counter their lies with truth, stand 10 toes down for America, and represent us the way that we should be represented. As citizens of this country, we deserve this and nothing less. Well, you see, with the current vice president, you get much less. You almost get nothing. I mean, think about it. Is she any better than Joe Biden? Joe Biden is senile. Joe Biden is facing dementia, allegedly. And I still think, y'all, at this point in time, I still think based on his career in Washington, he's still more qualified to be president than she is. Whose decision was it to go from bad to worse? Who chose to go from the skillet to the frying pan? Well, whoever's decision it was, whoever the puppet master is behind the scenes, that puppet master has shown that the deep state is incapable of running this country. And if we leave them in power, we are doomed because they are going to keep implementing policies like they've been implementing that have made America worse. And JD is right here letting you know, look, we are focused on the policies that are going to make America great. The economy. Americans need to be financially stable. The border. Americans need to be secure in their country. If you don't have a border, you don't have a country. Crime. Americans want to feel safe, not only in their homes, but when they step outside of those homes, running about their daily errands, going back and forth to work, back and forth to school, to the grocery store. Some people leave home and never return because crime is out of control in this country. Well, we got a president and a vice president that seem like they want to address these issues, y'all. And I hope you can see the stark difference between the parties. And when they send out these fake journalists with this fake news, you got to understand what you're looking at. This is the face of desperation. This is what it looks like when you get so desperate. You just want to throw anything against the wall and see if it sticks. Not only you, Kamala, but your journalistic operatives that we know are subscribed and loyal to the Democrat Party. Yeah. Thank you for sending them out, because they let us know exactly what we don't want as Americans. Y'all, let me know in the comments what you think about this. JD out here destroying these journalists one after the other after the other. Yeah, I feel confident that if anything was to happen to the commander-in-chief under a Trump administration, this man could step up. He could do the job. He could continue the mission that Donald Trump has set out on. Let me know, y'all. I'd love to know your thoughts on this topic. And don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time, peace.